The following is a presentation of TFNN. Live at TFNN, the Power Trading Hour, with your host, David White. Now, the author of The Path of Least Resistance and The Tech Insider, David White.
Maybe I'm not buying options at this moment, because it may take the rest of the week or even next week to let this play out. But right now we've got a opportunity where everything that the market makers thought that they ever were going to get is into this market. They got it at 1686, and if we close above that, I'm going to say that we're probably close to a flip of the coin. Below 1686 for today's close would be the last big gulp in this high. And if you go back to, what was it? Is it April? 1st of May of 2011? I'm going to say it was 2011. I'll go back and look at it tonight. But we've got kind of the same kind of pattern setting up right here, which is a very low volume rally into a very high of volume down move. And why everybody's focusing on the governmental issues out here, I suspect that there are some other issues coming that are going to make it a lot more difficult to see a up fourth quarter, especially with earnings over the next 3 or 4 weeks. Started seeing a few of those run through last night. Maybe we'll hit a few before the day is over. Nice big move out here. Volume, what is it, 2.1? Let's go ahead and fix that here. Hang on just a second. Okay, there we go. Yeah, still not right. I think I need one more. Hang on just 1 second here so I get this right. Nope, I wasn't right. There's something wrong here. I'm going to have to fix it here during the break. Anyway, looking at a lot of stocks and what they're doing, been pretty much going through them all day long. We've had some tests of the lows of some of these stocks that have come off the highs. But a lot of these things, with the exception of a lot of the stocks in the major indexes where people are having to buy, a lot of the ones that are smaller parts of those indexes are bouncing on what is not going to be a great volume today. Of course, when you look at the overall volume of the NYC consolidated tape, probably not a big surprise out here. You would think if this is truly the breakout that we're looking for, that would be it. But what this does set up is a air pocket below us where all the people that were shorting yesterday at the lows are squeezed out in a single day, setting up a opportunity for a gap down. And that gap down would probably happen on Monday if we don't get some kind of deal. I think the press is reporting the political agreement probably wrong. And my guess is that there are about 200 or so representatives in the House that do not answer to the Speaker of the House. They'll vote with him occasionally. But there's probably about 200 of them that are really not tracking with his leadership in the moment. And I don't care what he says he's got. I'm highly doubtful that if he doesn't show up with something over the weekend, come Monday, we get a vote on a temporary lift, that he is not going to have the votes. I think that there's a lot of wishful thinking at the moment. And maybe when we get more details out of this, but at first blush, this is just way too easy. And I have a feeling that they're going to make him come with at least something back to report. And if he doesn't, then we're probably not going to see this deal actually come together. So to me, the light volume out here is probably a lot of a disbelief and a lot of short covering. If you really want to see markets that are headed down, especially with a volume off the top, the best thing and the closest thing that I've seen in the last 15 years of trading is going to be much closer to the 2000 high in the dot-coms. This kind of movement that we're seeing today was an everyday occurrence for volatility. And pretty brutal out there, but 26-point moves, no big deal. 50, 75-point moves every day in the NASDAQ was not a big deal. And the worst thing that could happen, at least for the Fed and the current administration, is to start seeing volatility. We've talked about this for a while, and that is that everybody is pretty much forced to use the value at risk model since the laws changed with Dodd-Frank. And, of course, the only way that this market works is if they can continue to have very high leverage, and the only way to have very high leverage and still be within a Dodd-Frank is to have a very low volatility. As soon as we get anywhere close to about 18 or 20 on the VIX, everybody comes unglued up at Washington, because what you have is a market that is fundamentally flawed. That is, as it goes down, more and more people are going to have to sell, not for margin requirements, but because their value at risk models will not allow them to carry as much leverage as they would like to. They will have to, by law, sell to keep their value at risk model correct. So we have a model that we have a market that, much like Titanic, has a critical flaw. The Titanic could have stayed afloat, but it was, instead of all the compartments actually being sealed, they were only sealed till they got to a certain deck level. Above those, the water just trickled into the next compartment, much like a filling in an ice cube tray. You just tilt the ice cube tray a little bit and put the water in, and as it fills up the ones you're in, it'll just keep cascading down until all of them are filled. Well, that was the problem with the Titanic. They didn't cap off the top. They just assumed that it would never go over the top. There's always some critical flaw. The problem that we have with the markets now is Dodd-Frank, and that is that we have a market that can't handle the truth, can't handle high volatilities without enforcing selling, not because of margin requirements, but because of the value at risk model to stay within the market. And, of course, the Fed has been out there every time the market looked a little shifty to stand in the way of any kind of meaningful volatility change in the VIX. And the problem is that the more and more you reinforce the idea that a market can't fail or go down, all you are is bottling up the risk. Probably the best guy that is addressing this today is Nassim Taleb. I don't agree with everything he says. Mostly he's got some issues where the only way to trade is with options. I can understand what he does. But I don't think a lot of people have his mathematical background. Without it, I don't think you could duplicate what he does. Two, you'd have to have very deep pockets to start off with. And he had those by working with George Soros and some of the other big Wall Street guys. He didn't just start off and start his own fund. He actually proved his theories with other people's money. And he's probably writing the best out here. There, if you Google it, there's a few things that he's got where he is working on how to show people what the true risk is. And his latest book, Anti-Fragile, a good treatise on it. Most people probably are not going to get the core of it, but basically he's saying that, I think actually he does say it, that what we've done is give the government, who just took a brand new school bus full of kids and wrecked it, not only a new school bus, but a quart of vodka and a brand new set of kids to take over the cliff. And I can see what he's talking about, especially when you bring in the value at risk model forced on these folks. And of course, the amount of destruction you have in a bubble is always basically the proportional reverse of how much leverage there was when the bubble burst. And the worst thing we can see right now are articles like I brought up yesterday in General Motors, where they've got are approaching close to 10% of loans being overdue, and unsure exactly how many of those are going to actually be repos. But when you continue to push leverage not only on the American people, put leverage in the hands of Wall Streeters, that it isn't their money, it's other people's money. They're going to do whatever it takes, and heads we win and we walk out with huge salaries, tails we lose, and of course you're going to have to bail us out one more time. And you know, probably been the hugest transfer of wealth from the mid-class and lower classes to the upper class, which is something that everybody said that they didn't want to do, just the opposite. They wanted to spread the money around. And, of course, there's always the unintended consequence, and that's exactly been it. The rich have gotten extremely rich over the last 4 to 6 years based on pumping money from the Fed, and it really hasn't found the people that it was intended to. But that's almost always the way it is. The market will thwart you at every turn if you try to manipulate it. It kind of reminds me of the old commercial where it said, it's not nice to fool with Mother Nature. And I think the rules of the economy are probably not easy to fool with either. You can monkey with them for a while, but they will always catch up with us. We will be back in just a few minutes. Start looking at some charts and some news articles. Give me a call, 877-927-6648.
Andy Hecht, the host of the Commodities Hour, recently launched his newsletter service, the Technomental Commodity Report, and only 6 weeks in, Andy has already recorded a triple-digit winner. Andy advised his subscribers to purchase a long-term call option at 46 cents on July 11th, and then sent out a special update Friday, August 16th, advising his subscribers to close that position at $1.40. That's a 204% profit in just 5 weeks. The Technomental Commodity Report by Andy Hecht is released each Thursday morning, and right now you can get a month-long free trial to this subscription while locking in the low introductory rate of only $39 a month. Andy Hecht has been a commodities trader for over 3 decades. Let his experience work for you. Sign up for your month-long free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report today at TFNN.com.
With the launch of Tiger TV, TFNN has brought our programming to the next level. With Tiger TV, you can gain access to each host's charts and computer screens as they host their daily stock program. Whether it's Tom O'Brien, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, David White, Larry Pesavento, Andy Hecht, Victor Jones, or Daryl Martin, you can catch all of our technicians hosting their programs live and archived on Tiger TV for your viewing pleasure 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you haven't checked out Tiger TV, then visit TFNN.com and see what you're missing.
You've always taken the long view when it comes to investing, but what if there's an opportunity right under your nose? What if you could be more responsive to market trends to seek to boost your portfolio performance right now while seeking to reduce your overall risk? At Direction Funds, we connect investors with alternative strategies that seek to maximize their returns. Smart investors deserve smart alternatives. Find yours at directionfunds.com. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risk charges, and expenses of Direction Funds carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction Funds. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact the Direction Funds at 800-851-0511. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. Investing in index funds may be more volatile than investing in broadly diversified funds. Distributed by Rafferty Capital Markets, LLC.
Wouldn't it be great if you could get a red light, green light indicator that gives you signals on 25 different futures contracts? Now you can with TAS Signal Box. This red light, green light market profile system dynamically updates 24 hours a day and provides you with important trend and trade signals on 9 different commodities, 9 different indices, and 8 different currencies. Right now you can receive a 2-week free trial to TAS Signal Box. For all the details and to find out how the Signal Box works, visit the front page of TFNN.com. McEwen Mining is a high-growth, mid-tier producer in the Americas with a market capitalization of $1 billion. Experienced mining executive Rob McEwen, as chairman, CEO, and president, owns 25% of the outstanding shares of McEwen Mining and has put in place an ambitious business plan with the goal of qualifying for inclusion in the S&P 500 by 2015. With $70 million in cash and liquid assets as of the end of 2012 and completely debt-free, McEwen Mining is poised for growth. Production in 2013 is forecasted to grow at 24%, reaching 130,000 gold equivalent ounces. And over the next 3 years, McEwen Mining projects that their production will increase to 290,000 gold equivalent ounces, almost a threefold increase from last year's totals. If you'd like to find out more about McEwen Mining, click on their banner on the front page of TFNN.com or check them out on the NYSE or TSX under the symbol MUX.
Dave takes your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
And we're back. And what do we have going on here? I'm looking at the volume and price movement here and seeing if we have much. And, of course, it's 1683 on the S&P cash. What do we have going on? 2.2 billion shares. Again, we should be probably tracking around 2.6, 2.7 billion shares right now to get a higher volume break of the 1686 level. We went within just a hair of it at 1685.43, certainly into that candle, and another light volume move up here. Can we make it up to $1,700? Maybe tomorrow. It could be. I have a suspicion that if your stock is probably weak, you were thinking about pulling the trigger and going short on it, today's probably not a bad deal. A lot of the weak stocks will probably start breaking before any of these other stocks. And even if we go up to 1700 tomorrow, I suspect it will be short-lived unless we get some kind of volume before the end of the day. So what do we have moving in the market out here? CTXS. CTXS. If I put it in there, CTXS. There we go. Citrix Systems. And this one, of course, had earnings last night. I think Tom brought it up. Issued a downside guidance. Sees EPS of 68 to 69 cents versus the 73-cent estimate, and doesn't look good going forward. A lot of people lowered their target range, but their target range was still way above the last major highs out here, so I don't see a lot. Now they're down to 70 to 81 on it. I just don't see any of those numbers coming out of this thing anytime soon. Of course, Citrix Systems does a lot of cloud-based work, but they also do the PC Anywhere and all the other telecommunication software where you have meetings over video cameras, all that kind of stuff. But we've got huge volume, and this thing hit $58 even today with 11 million shares. There's an old low at 56.27 going back to November 15th of 2012. I suspect we're probably going to see that hit in the next few days. Gap and support come in at about same range, a little lower than 56, 55, 56. Yeah, probably in the 55 range. So we're probably going to see that. But not going to be uncommon is that we start seeing a lot of these companies announce at earnings that they are guiding down. A lot of these, it's the same thing that happens over and over again, and that is that analysts keep moving the numbers up, even though a lot of the corporate guys will say, hey, your numbers are probably looking a little too high. And they keep raising them every 3 months. And, of course, a lot of times weaker CEOs will say, oh, okay, I better make my numbers. And they keep shifting things forward and forward and forward. Eventually, the wheels fall off the wagon. This one had a very, very clear sell signal back about the $75 level. The January 31st high was $75.50 with 6 million shares. And we came back into that with 1.8 million shares on September 20th. Coming in with a third of the volume as you break highs is no way to break them. Always reminds me of Animal House. Fat, dumb, and stupid is no way to go through life, son. But anyway, third of the volume up here at the highs just wasn't much of anything. And, of course, not a big surprise to see this thing fall out of bed over the last few days. Other stocks of interest, Netflix. Netflix is coming up on earnings. I suspect this to be the blow-off top coming fairly shortly. This thing's pulled back from, 334.50 is a high just 4 or 5 days ago. What was that, October 3rd? We've made our bottom, and now this thing's probably going to get back up that 325 area, I suspect, for earnings. And if we get a nice 40 point bounce out of earnings when those come out, I think it's October 23rd, I think that will be the time to start pulling the trigger on this thing short. But I'm looking for one more major gap up in this thing. Anyway, we'll be back in a minute. Give me a call, 877-927-7648.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
No matter where you listen to TFNN programming, we want you to know you can always access your favorite shows on demand through TFNN.com. TFNN airs live programming every market day from 9 a.m. till 6 p.m. Eastern, and you can view each program by accessing Tiger TV through our homepage. We even have an easy link for all mobile devices, including iPhones and iPads, located at the top right-hand corner of the TFNN homepage. You can use your smartphone to view Tiger TV, but if you don't have a mobile connection that can keep up with streaming live video, then you can simply visit TFNN.mobi in the browser of your smartphone for live streaming audio of all of our programs. The mission of TFNN is to educate our audience directly and interactively through our interactive website and radio call and talk shows. TFNN is able to teach all levels of investors the technical skills needed to trade in today's marketplace. In order to get the best information possible, TFNN has assembled the most respected financial minds in the country to provide the most current news and comprehensive advice available. TFNN.com. Educating investors.
Daryl Martin coined the phrase diagnostic trading, and we're happy to announce that his diagnostic box spread analyzer has finally been released. The Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer helps you easily identify the best box spreads on Nadex in seconds, plus you receive access to the diagnostic deviation levels, as well as step-by-step training videos teaching you how to trade Nadex spreads so you can quickly master the mechanics of this simple yet powerful trading instrument. By pulling live data from the Nadex Exchange, the Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer does all the math for you, calculating risk, reward potential, distance to break even for both outright spreads and spreads used to hedge the underlying market. Visit the front page of TFNN.com today to get your two-week free trial to Daryl Martin's Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer and gain access to the valuable information it can provide when trading the Nadex box spreads. Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
This segment is brought to you by Harmony Gold. For more information, just click the Harmony Gold banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
As we come back after the bell tonight, we don't have a lot going on, at least for the list I have. But we do have one, and that's probably been the hottest stock for the last 3 or 4 weeks, and that is Micron Technology. Symbol is MU, and it's hard to tell. We're getting a little doji out here today. Hard to say what these guys are going to say after the bell. I would tell you what the truth is going to be, and that is that we've gone to all, if I was talking for the CEO, we've gone to major highs when we were trading not that long ago at $5. We're trading nearly four times that right now. And the reason why is that we bought out a company, and that company used to be our competitor. And one of our other competitors had a fire and can't produce anything. So we had two things going for us. We had a competitor go out of business and the other competitor catch fire. Now, how long that lasts, probably tough. I don't see any reason on going short here now. But every commodity company eventually goes back to being a commodity. It can, for a while, have a head up why they're repairing the other company. And I'm trying to get numbers on that. But probably a few days after the other company that had the fire starts making more memory chips yet again, we're probably going to see probably a good chance that this thing, I imagine when it does crack, it's going to crack and race right back down to the $14 level. Because almost all of this has been from the $13 level has been attributed to even higher DRAM prices or memory prices after the major competitor caught fire. And those conditions do not last. And, of course, if you're the company that caught fire and you're finally making huge money and margins on memory, you want to get back into operation just as fast as possible. And, of course, Micron in the right place at the right time. I don't know when this does start heading down. But when it does, it's no different than a gold or silver company other than they actually manufacture a product instead of dig it out of the ground. But in memory, one of the things you need to know is that you have to make it to a standard, which means that you're not going to have something that's that far or that different than everybody else. It's how well you control costs, much like a mine. And that makes it very tough to keep these kind of margins going for long. And as soon as the traders in this see the first hint that those margins are headed south, they are going to be out of this big time. And I imagine this thing probably could get back to 10 bucks over time. But I think the first jump down is going to be around to that gap level at the 14 that is probably going to get filled. And I'm watching the Japanese newspapers to find out when that plant's going to reopen. I haven't seen anything quite yet other than they think they can get maybe in the next couple of weeks that they can actually get maybe the thing back up, and then probably another 4 weeks to get it online. It takes a while to get all the trash out of a clean room facility like they are working on. Other stocks of interest that are moving today, it is Baidu, B-I-D-U. Let's take a quick look at some of these on the very high side. Again, I was talking, I forget who it was. We're talking about talking about the double repo pattern and what we need to be watching for in this marketplace if you want to start putting on shorts, because there is a very good likelihood that we're going to have at least the pattern confirm itself here shortly. I've talked about the Joe DiNapoli double repo pattern. That is 10 to 15 days above the 9-day simple moving average or 3-day displaced moving average. You want a couple of days below it. You want a couple of days above that line. And then if you've had very light volume in these last few days as it goes back above that 3-day moving average, displaced moving average, or 9-day simple moving average, when it comes back below that line again, you go ahead and pull the trigger. And it is a lot of times extremely effective, especially when you have parabolic markets. This is not something that you do every day, but we've had so many of these that it's this one, especially in Baidu, would be very interesting. Of course, we had two of the huge volume down days that broke through that line. Now we're coming back up on light volume, and it may take a couple of days. But look for that to go above the line, close back below it, and then that normally is a fairly good sign that a top and a long-term top is in on parabolic moves in the market. Not a lot of volume, still stuck at 1683 on the S&P cash, 2.25 billion shares. We should be doing something like about 2.9 billion right now for this to stick and really give us some kind of indication that we're going to blow away 1730. I just don't see it right now in any of the stocks I'm looking at or in the main indexes. Let's take another look and see what else we have moving out here. Wynn Resorts, W-Y-N-N. And on this one, this one's still staying. Well, you had 2 days. Probably not as good, but I would. This one, it's close. I like to see a little bit more piercing of the 9-day or 3-day displaced moving average. In fact, why don't we try that to see how that looks? You got it, but you would like to see light volume. So what do we have compared to the last high on the 3rd? It came in with 2.2 million shares. And what do we have today? 852,000 shares. So watch a lot of these things. They're going to be way above the moving average. They're going to go below it. They're going to pop back above it. And then the next move down below, if you're thinking you're bearish on this market, that is when start pulling the trigger when you've got confirmation lower. Again, you can give us a call at 877-927-6648. That's 877-927-6648. And if you go to the front page of TFNN, you can check out a special promotion for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien's coming up with his 600th edition, and you can check that out. That'll be interesting. I'm sure Tom will be talking about it more tonight and in depth. I actually sent him several charts over the last couple of days, and I think we're getting awful close for those people that do get and subscribe to the Art of Timing and Trade Charts. You're knowing and seeing some of those start to show up in the scan. And, of course, we're just getting the first taste of a few of these that are looking good. But, you know, gold's down today. What is it down, 10 bucks still? It's 10 bucks on the nose, 12.97.20. I suspect we're going to see at least a 12.75 again. And whether we break through that or not is going to tell me and what kind of volume we have there. It's going to tell me whether or not this is the final consolidation move, or we're going back down to 1,200 bucks and maybe a little less on gold. I probably would not buy gold here or gold miners unless we get that super blowout. And that is all the people that bought the last low that are hanging on to it and going to continue to have problems. A lot of people just won't sell. I had a lot of money very quickly, and that was it. Anyway, 1275. Break 1275 takes us back down to 1200, and I'd love to see that to set up my next long-term buy of gold. But why ask me? You can always go to Tom O'Brien, who's been doing a gold report now for 600 editions. Let me check a few things out. Oh, we got my webinar, too. Forgot to talk about that. Tom and I will be doing a webinar on Wednesday, and we'll be doing that on the 16th at 6:30. Anybody that is a subscriber can sign up for it at tfnn.com. And, of course, if you don't have the Art of Timing and Trade Charts, you can sign up and get the first 30 days, if you've had no previous trials, for $1. So a good way to test that out. And, again, check on the front page of TFNN for that. What else do we have on here? Garmin, Fossil. Let's see if there's anything else out here. I got somebody asking a question. Another confluence. I guess I could probably do something. Don't know what we're going to talk yet. I'll be talking to Tom O'Brien tomorrow, and we'll be trying to figure out what we're looking for. But maybe it's a good time for me to do another run, confluence run. We'll be discussing that probably tomorrow before we do the Tech Insider Hour. Cool. We'll have to see. A lot of those confluence numbers worked out pretty good. Maybe we'll do a little bit of research and see how those worked. Okay, what else? Let's go. Just seeing if we've got any real movement here in this market. So hang on just a second as I look, because I see a few things moving out here. Not really. Still less than 2.3 billion shares. Okay, so let's go back and see what we have moving to the downside. Of course, we talked about Citrix, Green Mountain Coffee Roasters off almost 2.5%, Intuitive Surgical's off 1%, Monster Energy Drinks kind of flat, and that's about it in the NASDAQ 100 of the big down movers. Not many out here, but again, just not the kind of volume you think would make this stick up at the highs. Let's go ahead and see what I have out here to see. I think there were a few. Wanted to look at a few of these housing stocks. Let me turn that off so it's a little bit more visible about what we're doing. We've got Toll Brothers been bouncing around off these lows. One thing I dislike about this low, it did come in lower. It has pierced the June 21st low, which had a lot of volume, 11 million shares, came back, tried to pierce it again on September 5th. Volume was 3.9. Of course, got a nice little bounce out of that. Now we got 5.6 million shares, which is something I don't like to see, which is increased volume of a previous low, even if it is been tested already, in this case, 11 million shares. I'm not real bearish here. I'm just suspecting that we're probably going to need to come back into this just under $30 range one more time on Toll Brothers under $30 and see some very light volume out here that we haven't seen now. I just don't like to see increasing energy at lows from the previous low. That one certainly looked good at $29.85 on September 5th, but still problematic. See if we find something else here. We've been talking about a lot of these solar companies, especially with the problem with fuel prices dropping. Makes solar and solar energy companies and alternative energy companies harder to do. And even in some of these very inexpensive ones like SunTech Power, which is STP, we're seeing this thing challenge previous highs. This one got right up to some fairly nice highs with volume and instantly rolled over yesterday. January 4th high and the January 17th high were both in the 190s, high 190s, with a lot of volume. You had 10 million shares, had plenty of volume. But this thing could not hold it yesterday. Another one in that same vein is Solar City. Now, this one would be very interesting, especially if you start seeing the energy sector start to move down with lower prices, because this certainly is a kind of a setup for an ABC down. I would have liked to seen this last leg have less energy, but we basically have one big day out here. And it's been moving kind of sideways and just a little higher. But I guess, what's today? Today's Thursday. So I've got my stalker back. I've got Andy Heck. He'll be following us today. And that will be interesting. Maybe his tech on it, on his call on energy would be apropos to looking at some of these solar companies that are way off their highs, come back up, and for the most part haven't seen a lot of volume or, in this case, what I'm looking at, I suspect, distribution. SCTY, another one to be taking a look at. We'll look at a few more stocks as we wait for Andy to warm up in the bullpen. We'll be back in a minute.
Patterns, profits, and peace of mind.
Are you looking for a precision edge in the market? Something that can stack the odds in your favor? Then look into Larry Pesavento's trading newsletter.
Patterns, Profits, and Peace of Mind.
In each weekly issue, Larry explains what's going to happen in the markets based on the pattern he sees developing and gives you actionable trade ideas based on those patterns. Plus, you'll get his detailed analysis on a variety of markets and sectors, including stocks, treasury bonds, the gold market, oil, the dollar, the Forex market, and more. You'll get access to all the patterns Larry is seeing in the markets, plus the Astro Harmonics and powerful Bradley stock market model that Larry utilizes for less than $5 a day. An extremely potent combination that will give you the edge you've been looking for. Try Patterns, Profits, and Peace of Mind absolutely free for 2 full weeks. That's an $85 value. Yours free when you register right now.
Get Larry's Patterns, Profits, and Peace of Mind.
And get the edge you've been looking for.
TFNN has just announced a special sale for 2 weeks only for the Gold Report. To celebrate the 600th weekly issue of Tom O'Brien's Gold Report being published on October 22nd, TFNN is having a special one-time sale. From now until October 22nd only, you can receive 60 weeks of the Gold Report, that's 14 months, for only $600. We're offering Tom O'Brien's dynamic weekly newsletter at only $10 a week, which is almost half off the regular monthly price. The Gold Report is published every Tuesday and provides subscribers with Tom O'Brien's expert commentary on the industry, as well as detailed information on a variety of mining equities. Take advantage of this one-time special offer and pay only $600 for 60 weeks of the Gold Report. This offer is valid for current or new subscribers. Everyone is welcome to take part in this special promotion as we celebrate the 600th weekly issue of the Gold Report. All the details are on the front page of TFNN.com.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
What's the one thing that pulls people back from the breakthrough that they're moving towards? What's the only thing that really stops people from taking action? You and I both know the answer, and sure, we can come up with the reasons why we're not where we want to be, but the only reason that we don't do more with our life is fear. Or if you're an overachiever, call it stress. Simply put, there's something that happened to us in our past that's holding us back from the life we deserve, yet you and I are okay, we're here. So why should we let our past control our future? Exactly. We shouldn't. Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes with TFNN.com, and when it comes to your trading and investing, I can help you overcome your fear of loss. Together, we'll turn weakness into strength with a system I've developed called Mastering Probability. I'll teach you how to make your money work harder for you than you do for it. I'll teach you the tools that provide financial freedom. Go to the homepage of TFNN.com, click on my name, Steve Rhodes, and begin your journey of mastering probability risk-free. It's time to become a pioneer of your future versus a prisoner of your past.
Join Andy Hecht as he teaches you how to make money in commodities. The Commodities Hour, next on TFNN.
Well, you can still play it. You want to try? You got it? Eh, things going too fast. Made a mistake. We were going to introduce Andy new theme music. He's got apparently they've got it all set up at TFNN, but just didn't get to it today, so we'll try it next Tuesday maybe. Oh, there we go. There he is. Andy's theme music. There he is. He's stalking me. I can see his fin. He's out there in the ocean. He's after me. Most jaws are not that nice. They don't come exactly when you ask them to at 3 o'clock to 4 o'clock on TFNN.com. But apparently he's a good shark, well-mannered, and knows exactly when to show up, and only on certain days. So I guess if I didn't want to get eaten by jaws, I'd just go Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays out into the ocean. Anyway, we've got Marcus still just sitting here kind of doing a little tap dance because I want to be watching this volume and see if it picks up at all. 2.3 billion shares on the consolidated New York Stock Exchange tape. Any kind of volume, folks. It's 3 o'clock, and there's just not spit here. So we are, you know, when you come up, especially get a nice 27-point move in the S&P cash today, you should have a sign of strength, which is a big candle, which we have, with a big volume, and that probably should be 4.2, 4.5 billion shares today to really get a sense that everybody's buying into this. As I looked at the options during the break, I also see that a great deal of the option market makers are now starting to buy downside protection. which makes me think that they are, now that they've got this market up here, that they're going to try to be selling into it for the next few days. Maybe they aren't buying the political leaders all joining hands and singing a kumbaya like I am. I am very wary of this whole deal. I think it smacks as a lot of optimism where I just don't see a signed deal yet. And I think we could get into Sunday and find this thing blown apart fairly easily. Of course, look for that close above at 1686 with some kind of volume maybe by the end of the day. But I just don't see it now. And like I said, I took today as an opportunity to find some low-hanging fruit. And add some shorts, and probably a percent better already. They've already rolled over, and I'm going to be watching some of these others out here. But I've got three positions now. I'm going to start looking at adding through next week, because I think when we get to next week, we're probably going to start seeing this market weaken somewhat. So I want to see if there was anything else here I really wanted to look at real close. UNG, this thing keeps on taunting everybody. Of course, I don't think we're going to be seeing a lot of government numbers here anytime soon, but I don't see a lot of cold weather either. I'd be watching the weather reports. Maybe Andy's been doing that. And I thought it was just when it was safe to get back into the water with Andy. Maybe he'll be out there cruising to take a big bite out of natural gas. But you never know. Just looking at this, I just don't see not a whole lot of energy in it either. Of course, we're not going to be getting EIA numbers, I don't think, this week either. So we'll have to see. Anyway, see you tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time, in studio tomorrow, and then the Tech Insider tomorrow night. See you then.
Are you ready to ride the next bull market wave? Catch the Chapman Wave. Using the Chapman Wave methodology, Basil's very comprehensive daily newsletter, The Opening Call, gives the short, intermediate, long-term analysis for the key indexes. In his Trader's Corner, he gives a brief market summary and expectation for the day with possible trades, both long and short, which are reviewed daily. A position subscriber sold recently for a 42% on part, plus a 64% on rest, at Hertz Global, as a core position for 6 months before exiting the position. A current position, entered as a turnaround company with good technicals based on Basil's waveform, is trading up to 170% of its entry point as a portion sold earlier for a 21% gain. Subscribers to The Opening Call can see the Chapman Wave techniques demonstrated and explained daily to educate investors. To get your 2-week free trial to The Opening Call, just visit the front page of TFNN.com. Also, don't miss Basil's program, The Tiger Technician's Hour, Monday through Friday at 11 a.m. Eastern on TFNN.